So hello guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. In this video, we will be exploring the rotary dryer, a widely used drying apparatus in diverse industries around the globe. In this video, we will be looking into what is rotary dryer, its construction, working, advantages, disadvantages, and its application. So let's begin our discussion with what is rotary dryer. Okay, as the name says, a rotary dryer is a rotating piece of equipment that uses either a rotating drum or a cylinder to reduce the moisture content of the material which is fed into the rotary dryer. The wet materials are exposed to the hot air or hot gas, and thus the moisture is carried away with the current of hot air or gas. Now next, we will be looking into what is construction of rotary dryer. The rotary dryer is an adiabatic air heated dryer. A typical rotary dryer is shown in the figure, which is displayed on the screen. A rotating shell A, which is made up of steel and is supported by two set of rollers, which is denoted by B in the figure. The rollers are driven by gears and pinions, which is marked by C in the figure. There is a hood provided on the top which connects the fan to the stack, and a sprout that is used for the entrance of the feed. Hood is denoted by letter D, which is connected to the fan, denoted by E, and sprout used for feeding, which is denoted by letter F. The material which is to be dried is lifted by the flight G and poured down through the current of the hot air. These flights are welded inside the cell. The dried product is discharged into the screw conveyor, denoted by H, at the lower side of the dryer. There are steam heated extended surface pipes which are kept beyond the screw conveyor to preheat the air. So this was an overall construction of rotary dryer. Now moving on with working of rotary dryer. The working principle of rotary dryer involves the following steps. First is material loading. The wet material that has to be dried is fed into the rotary drum or the rotating drum or the cylinder of the rotary. This feeding of material is assisted through a feed conveyor, which is followed by drying medium introduction. Here, hot air or gas is introduced into the rotary dryer. The stream of hot air or gas can be heated directly through a flame generated by burning of fuel or by employing other heat exchange methods like steam or dielectric heaters. Then, next is material drying. The wet material that is fed to the drum of the rotary dryer rumbles within the dryer and comes in direct contact with the hot air or gas. The heat from the drying material, that is hot air or gas, is transferred to the wet material and thus causes moisture to evaporate. Now next is moisture evaporation. The water content in the wet material is converted into the vapors through the heat energy, and this is imparted from the drying substance. This will lead to increase in the humidity of the air or the gas which is used for drying the material. Moving on with vapor removal. The air that is now saturated with the moisture is vented out of the rotary dryer and is carried away to the separate exhaust system. So till here, the moisture is totally removed from the material which is to be dried, and the vapor is carried away out of the exhaust system. Now it is about material discharge. In the material discharge, it is desired that wet materials attain the desired value of moisture content after it is discharged from the rotary dryer, which is through an outlet that is provided at the end of the drum. And last is about the recovery and recycling. As such, the drying medium that is generally used is air, which is free of cost. But the heat energy which is required to heat the air may be needed to be recovered. This is done by increasing the energy efficiency and reducing the operating cost. So these were the steps by which we discussed about the working of a rotary dryer, where we discussed about the material loading, then after material loading, how which medium is used to dry the material, how the material gets dry, how the moisture is evaporated and the vapor is been removed out of the system, out of the rotary dryer. then how the drying material is been discharged, and if necessary, about the recovery and recycling of the heat or the energy used for drying. One important thing which is to be discussed here is that the drum that rotates ensures that the wet material is exposed uniformly to the drying medium, otherwise improper drying will be carried out. This is to improve the efficiency of drying. The speed and inclination of rotating drum can be adjusted to regulate the residence time of the wet material in the dryer, and this will allow better process control and optimization. Means that for regulating the residence time, the speed and inclination of rotary dryer plays an important role. Furthermore, in this topic, now we will be looking into the advantages of rotary dryer. First advantage of rotary dryer is high drying capacity. So imagine a dryer that can handle a whole mountain of wet clothes all at once. That's why rotary dryer is like for all industries. It can dry huge amount of stuff super quickly, making it very perfect for big tasks. The next advantage is that energy efficiency. Rotary dryers are not just strong but also smart. They are like dryers that knows how to save energy. They can use leftover heat from other machines or even use special energy sources, which means that they do not waste energy and helps to save money. The third advantage of rotary dryer is versatility. A rotary dryer is like a drying expert that can dry almost anything you throw at it. From crops to minerals to special chemicals, it can handle all of them. That's why different industries love using it. The next advantage is uniform drying. Assume a dryer that treats all your wet stuff fairly. A rotary dryer is like that. It spins around, make every part of your material gets the same amount of drying heat. So no more wet spots or uneven drying. Next advantage is easy operation. Rotary dryers are designed in such a way that it is very easy to use. Like pressing a button and you can even let it work by itself. It is super easy to use. The last disadvantage is that reduced dust emission. We all know that dust flying around can be annoying and not good for us. But rotary dryer takes care of it and keeps all the dust inside a magic box, making the work area cleaner and safer for everyone operating around it or operating it. So these were 6 advantages of rotary dryer. Nextly, we will be discussing about disadvantages of rotary dryer. So the first disadvantage of rotary dryer is potential material degradation. When using a rotary dryer, we need to be cautious because high temperature or rough tumbling can lead to material damage or unwanted changes in its property. Next disadvantage is that it is having a high initial investment. Setting up a rotary dryer requires a sustainable upfront investment for purchasing the equipment and setting up the necessary infrastructure, which is also followed by ensuring proper maintenance. This all requires initial high investment. The third disadvantage is about high space requirement. Rotary dryers are designed to handle a lot of material, which makes them quite large and bulky. As a result, they need a considerable amount of space for installation and smooth operation. Next is heat loss. During the drying process, some heat can escape from the rotary dryer, which may affect its overall energy efficiency. The fifth disadvantage is that risk of fire and explosions. We all know that safety is a paramount when dealing with flammable or combustible materials. If not handled properly, the drying process can pose a risk of fire or explosion. And lastly, the disadvantages of rotary dryer includes dust and emission control. While rotary dryers are designed to keep dust inside, managing and controlling the emissions from the dryer's exhaust is necessary. So these were about advantages and disadvantages of rotary dryer. At last, for this topic now, we'll be looking towards its application, which is application of rotary dryer. We all know that rotary dryer are a magical machine that helps industries dry all sort of stuffs like mineral crops, chemicals, and many more. Industries like mining, agriculture, food processing, and even pharmaceuticals use these fantastic dryers. They are like the superheroes in the drying world because they can handle big lot of material, saving time and efforts. What's even cooler is that dryers are super smart too. They can save energy and are friendly to environment. Plus, they can dry almost anything you throw at them, making them perfect for different industries. So, next time when you see a massive rotating machine at an industrial site, remember that it's a rotary dryer, working its magic to keep the things dry. So guys, that's all for this video. Hope you like this video. Thank you for watching. And if you find this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more informative content related to chemical engineering, process engineering, chemical safety, industrial safety. And as always, feel very free to leave any questions or comment down below. Thanks for watching and see you in next video.